That you've been called out of the dark into the marvelous light. Do you know who you are?
The spirit that a lot of you guys out there that claim to be teachers, you're actually babes, man.
That's right.
And that's why the brother brought out that precept in Hebrews 5 and 12. And really, if you want to be quoting precepts from the New Testament, okay, you need to listen to the brothers that are bringing out the new wine. Because the New Testament is called New Testament because it's new wine.
That's right.
Right, we're the Hebrew Israelites, this Church of Yahushua, 144, first circle, second circle, link up again. Alright, we're gonna open out, we're gonna face the east, we're gonna say Allah, Allah,
Allah, Allah,
Yahweh,
Yahweh,
Baha Shama,
Baha Shama,
Yahweh Sha'ai,
Yahweh Sha'ai,
Baraka Atha,
Baraka Atha.
I wanna give double honors to Apostle Tahara, who taught us this truth. I wanna give a sincere Shalawama, Mahaba to the sincere brothers out there. Okay, that are pushing the word in truth and sincerity. We're out here again today. Alright, so we're gonna go into the tribe of Ra'awabana, right, which is Reuben. Some of you know it as Reuben in English. But the Lashawana Kodasha is what? Ra'awabana.
Ra'awabana.
So we're gonna break that down pertaining to raising up the heads, because for you brothers that used to be in the Church of Yahweh Sha'ai, you might remember I told you that we was lying in wait, which was what? Tazadaha. Lying in wait. And after Tazadaha is what? Manra Asha. Which is what? Raising up the heads.
Good.
And who was the head son of Yaikwaba?
Ra'awabana.
So that's what we're gonna go into today, right? So I'm gonna break down the name Ra'awabana real quick. You know, so get me that board, Malika. Right, so Ra'awabana, for those of you that hate the Lashawana Kodasha, you ain't gonna get this, man. You know what I mean? Ra'awabana, okay? So we gonna break it down. So the first character, Ra, is what? It's basically the head of a man. Ra'asha, it's the head of a man. So that's the first character. So that shows you that he's what? The head. Or the big brother. Let me just put big brother. Because he was the first son of Jacob. So he would have been the big brother of the 10 tribes, right? Because Benjamin wasn't born at that time yet. So the rest of the 10 brothers, he was the big brother. So I just put Ra'ah goes back to head or big brother. And Ah goes back to what? Alapa. But in this case, we're going to say to learn or to teach. That's in Job, innit? Atarif. Yeah. So we'll put that in the video just to show them. Because Alapa also goes back to teach or to learn. Alright, so he was the big brother that what? The younger brothers,
that's
man. Because a lot of times, you know, when they mention the tribes, the first tribe they go for is Judah. But you keep forgetting how great the tribe of Reuben is as well. Reuben was actually, you know,
I think I got a particular side for that.
The first son of Jacob, so it means that he will have most of the talents of the other tribes.
First Chronicles 5, I believe.
Yeah, first point, yeah, about, yeah, it was Reuben. Yeah, so Reuben, yeah.
Judah.
So Reuben is a very serious tribe, man. He ain't a joke tribe. So Ra, Ah, and then Wa is obviously a connector, you know, so we don't have to break that down. And Ba is what?
Bayafa,
which means house. And Na means what? Nana.
Which is seed, which is the head.
Which is also seed, or it means older. Elder.
Like the elder.
Seed or elder.
Like they say, the head nigga in charge. That's how the Jacob America say, the head nigga in charge.
Yeah.
That's the Nana.
Nana. So this is Nana. And what do you call your grandfather? Nan.
Nana.
Nana. You call him, you say my Nan.
I'm going to my nan's house.
Grandma. When West Africa, we say Nana.
You know?
Nani.
Nana. You got Nani as well, that Nani.
So you got by a far.
I come from Ivory Coast to my room.
You know what I mean? So this is serious, man. And you got Allah. You got Allah Pa. And then you got what? Ra'asha. It means head, head. Ra'asha. Right, so that's the breakdown for Reuben. So basically, Reuben is the big brother who taught the house of Israel, man, because seed goes back to Israel. You know? So he was the elder brother that taught the Biafar, the house of Israel.
That's right.
So that's the breakdown for Reuben, man. Alright? The first son of your Iquaba. You're gonna break it down, you're gonna understand. When we finish this lesson, you're gonna realize that the new wine is legit.
You're gonna learn today, man.
Right?
You're gonna learn.
That's it right there, man.
That's cool, it's cool.
Yeah,
that's
so cool. you can wipe the board, man. Right, so we're gonna get straight into this, man. So this is the new wine breakdown, okay, for Ra'awabana. And that ties into what? Kwam Ra'asha.
That's right.
Because Kwam means rise and Ra'asha means head.
That's right.
That's why the brothers know who they are in the spirit. Because what? Even the ones that don't believe the new wine, you've been told what tribe you're from, okay, and all of that. So when the Koboko comes, that's when it's gonna make sense. Alright? Right now we're just telling you what it is. Alright? So we're gonna get this thing started, man. Right, so concerning the tribe of Reuben, we must first revisit the prophecy by way of the blessing of Ya'aquaba, of his sons before he died. Okay? Because before Ya'aquaba was gathered unto the ancestors, he blessed his sons and he told them what will happen to them in the end times. And the prophecy concerning what will happen to them is how we figure out which tribe is which tribe as well. Because like we said, little key details in your life link you to your tribe. You know? Like for example, if you're from the tribe of Levi, you're gonna find yourself around a lot of law enforcement. You know? Or things to do with, you know, the gospel. You know, like the law.
Are you gonna understand? You're gonna be a good teacher.
A good teacher, you know, stuff like that, man. So, and these can only be spiritually discerned. Alright? So that shows you the brothers that don't agree with the new wine. You're not spiritual, man. You say you're spiritual, but your actions are proven different. Right, so concerning the tribe of Reuben, we must first revisit the prophecy by way of the blessing of Ya'aquaba of his sons before he died. Genesis, Genesis chapter 49 verses 1 to 4. So we're going to read the prophecy concerning Ra'awabana.
Bring that up.
Right? Because Ra'awabana is a tribe that is overlooked by the 12 tribes, man. Because like we said, when you Jakes find out you're Israelites, the first tribe they go for is Judah. Everyone wants to be Judah, innit? Or even if they don't say they're Judah, they say I'm a Jew. Which really goes back to Judah as well.
Right.
But you keep forgetting, the rest of the tribes are also unique in their own way.
Yes.
And Ra'awabana is actually a good tribe, man.
What's the name of the tribe?
And after we do the breakdown, Reuben. You're going to realize Ra'awabana, Reuben. Right? So read Genesis 49 and 1 to 4. Genesis 49, 1 to 4.
Okay, so this is Israel's prophecy concerning his sons. This is Genesis chapter 49, verse 1. And Jacob called unto his sons and said, gather yourselves together, that I may tell you that which shall befall you in the last days.
In the what?
In the last days.
In the what?
In the last days.
And we're in the last days right now of Esau's empire, right? So this prophecy has to come out. We need to show you who the tribe of Ra'awabana is, because what? That ties into what? Sha season, man. All right? And you're going to understand why we're doing all of this, man, after the breakdown, you know, after we get deeper into the breakdown. You're going to understand why we're breaking down the tribe of Ra'awabana. Because you got to remember, Ya'aquaba said, Ra'awabana, thou art the beginning of my strength. So that means, and Sha goes back to strength. Sha, teeth. The beginning of a child's strength is his teeth, right? So Ra'awabana is going to play a pivotal role in Sha's season, man. All right?
Verse 2. Gather yourselves together and hear ye sons of Jacob, and hearken unto Israel your father. Verse 3. Reuben, thou art my firstborn.
Thou art what?
Thou art my firstborn. My might and the beginning of my strength.
And the beginning of what?
And the beginning of my strength.
So that means the beginning of the Sha season is going to tie into the tribe of Ra'awabana being revealed. So that's how we know Sha season is coming, man.
That's right. That's right, right around the corner.
That's why they're on strike today, because I damn near had to flip and climb the mountain to get here today.
I'm telling you.
But through the spirit and power of Yahweh Shema Yahweh Sha'ai, I was able to come, man. All right? And even meet a brother in the process, just to give him a final warning about the name of the Lord. So that's all spiritual, man. All right? So we understand what's going on out here.
That's right.
But we know brothers ain't going to get down until the Lord gets laid
down.
And you're going to get that in Sha season, because I told you I had a dream about a brother hiding in the bushes, right? So that's the spirit. The Most High is just trying to tell us that we know you're watching, but you're just playing hard. Because Jacob is what? Stiff-necked.
Yeah, stuck in the ego and the pride. That's what it is.
All right, so read that.
It says you better get down or later.
Later. Yes, that's right.
The excellence, get down with the program of your Vashem Yashem.
The excellency of dignity.
The what?
The excellency of dignity.
And excellency of dignity talks about being famous. Because after we do the breakdown, you're going to realize that the most famous people that you know, which are, you know, so-called Negroes today, they go back to what? The tribe of Reuben, man. The excellency of dignity. Becoming a dignity, a dignified person, or a dignity of society means someone that's respected, renowned. All right? And after we do the breakdown, you're going to realize, man. Read that.
And the excellency of power.
And the what?
And the excellency of power.
And that power goes back to Sha.
Troy.
Shana. Power, man. Okay? So this breakdown is going to tie into the Sha season, man. You know, this could even be the curtain opener for Sha season. Okay?
Through the Spirit.
Verse 4. Unstable as water.
And what?
Unstable as water.
And what?
Unstable as water.
Right? Now remember it said unstable as water, because that's going to tie into one of the so-called superstar Reubenites that we're going to go into. So remember that term, unstable as water. Right, read.
Thou shalt not excel.
Thou shalt what?
Thou shalt not excel.
That's why a lot of the tribes, they don't like to identify. That's why a lot of the tribes don't like to identify as being from the tribe of Ra'awabana. Okay? Why? Because Ikwaba put a curse on him and said, you're not going to excel like the rest of the tribes. But that doesn't take away from the fact that they're still a very talented tribe. Okay? Exactly, but now, but you know, they had short careers. We'll go into that. Because a lot of the Reubenites that were into the football and that, the Samba boys, they had short careers, man. You know, they got devastated with injuries that they couldn't recover from. They had a short career, man. Okay? There's so many of them that we can mention. The Ronaldo number nines, the Patos, Kaká, all these guys, man. Rivaldos, all these guys. They had short careers, man. Even Ronaldinho, he didn't have a long career. You know? So. Yeah, but let me break it down. Right, so it says, Jacob gives us a clear perspective on the uniqueness of Reuben among his brethren, being the first fruits of his loins, because Reuben was the first fruits of Yahweh, so that means he's going to be the creme de la creme.
Right.
That's why Yahweh said, well, anything that openeth the matrix is mine, because that's the best, you know? Right, so it says, the uniqueness of Reuben among his brethren, being the first fruits of his loins, the beginning of his strength pertains to him possessing the attributes of sexual prowess over the tribes, both in the size of his previous member and his overall performance during courtship with females. Because we've said this many times, when it comes to the bedroom game, no one lays it down like Ra'awabana. That's a fact, okay? And if you think we're lying, you can go to Southern Africa and ask the daughters of Shiloh how things are going down over there. You see what I'm trying to say? Or even in Brazil, man. You could go to Brazil and talk to the women in the favela and see if you can take them home with you. You might get it right, but you can't take it home.
No, I'm talking about even the Congolese people.
Well, there you go.
What's going on with the Shamukwale. They dance a lot with the waist in it.
And you
that's the sign right there, man.
You know, it's funny because years ago, right, I went to my uncle's, one of my uncle's weddings. This was like when I was younger, like in my early teens. And then I seen this Congolese girl. I was trying to talk to her. You know what her mom said to me? Her mom said, hey, don't talk to her. We are Congolese people. She told me, she was like, nah, man. Don't come around us, man. Because we are Congolese. The way she said it is her, yeah. She was trying to tell me, you can't handle this, bro. She was like, we're Congolese, man. And I'm like, so what are you doing at this wedding then? You know? Obviously, you know, she's a family friend. You know what I mean? So, hey, through the spirit of discernment, you know, that's what it means, man. Right, so it says, the beginning of his strength pertains to him possessing the attribute of sexual prowess over the tribes, both in the size of his previous member and his overall performance during the courtship with females. Alright? It says, although this may seem like a sought after trait to inherit, you know, because everyone wants to be the guy. Everyone wants to be the guy that can lay down the pipe, innit? So although this may seem like a sought-after trait to inherit, this same supposedly coveted attribute will be his demise.
What?
Okay, as he succumbed to utilizing it on his own father's concubine, Bilha, which in turn activated the curse on the Reubenites. Okay, so get the definition for Bilha. Now we'll go back to it, but we're jumping around, innit? So get definition for Bilha and read what it means. Bilha. Because that will show us how the Reubenite women are as well. Because like I said, when you go to Brazil, the Reubenite women have that spirit of Bilha in them. Because a lot of people go to Brazil to do what?
Hold on.
A lot of people go to Brazil for what? Sex tourism.
That's right.
That's the curse, man. You know? That's the curse. Everyone goes to sleep with Ruben's wife.
Go to the pool and
have fun.
Go there and put Bilha. Bilha.
Yeah.
B our tribe. Bilha.
B-I-L-H-A-H. Bilha.
I think it's slow, man. That area is just.
Yeah, like, Bilha. It's in the pool. Yeah.
There's not the pool.
Well, I don't care.
Yeah, Bilha.
Bilha, you can find it.
You know, go to the closing. Yeah, Bilha, click on it and then go to. Yeah, look in the Bible.
No,
the second one, yeah, that one. Go back. Yeah, Malaka, can you do it for him? So, yeah, so get Bilha. Alright. It says, although this may seem like a sought after trait to inherit, this same supposedly coveted attribute will be his demise as he succumbed to utilizing it on his own father's concubine, Bilha. Alright? Which in turn activated the curse on the Reubenites' women being the number one choice for hiring in the prostitution industry, man. Alright? And you brothers know it, man. Okay? You know the number one so-called slags are the so-called Brazilians, man.
Malaka, we're gonna have to put it on the
scene.
It's not working.
That's because of Reuben. Alright? That's because of the curse that was put on Reuben. That's why through the spirit they have what? The carnival, man. And you see how they dress at the carnival half naked. That's spiritual, man.
The spirit of Shabakas.
There you go. But it's all tied into why Reuben went and approached his father's bed. That's why everyone's taking Reuben's woman for a ride now. You understand? That's spiritual, man. That can only be spiritually discerned.
Well, we can't.
Yeah, yeah, but click on it. Let me see. If, yeah, interlinear. So Bilha. Yeah, he's going. He's going. Go to Bilha.
Like really,
I'm not
gonna have to go to the
right. So, definition for Bilha as well.
Okay, so the outline of biblical usage for Bilha equals trouble.
Equals what?
Trouble.
Equals what?
Trouble.
Right. Now click on it again. Root word definition again.
Root word. This one.
Yeah. Okay. You can click on that word. Click on it. What does it say? Go into it twice.
Right. Okay, so the root word etymology for Bilha is the outline of biblical usage for Bilha means PL to trouble.
To what?
To trouble.
To trouble.
To trouble.
Yeah. Because those type of women, they'll get you set up as well.
That's right.
You know the women in the favela, they look good.
Oh yeah, yeah.
But they'll get you set up, man. They'll say papi, come, papi. As soon as you get in there with them, you see some Reubenites will run up in there.
Yeah, man.
They'll rob you. Yeah, you might even get killed.
You'll get killed.
So these Reubenite women, they got the spirit of Bilha on them, man. And that's all spiritually discerned, all right? And that's why when you go to Brazil, you know, it's just a cesspool of whores, man.
Yeah, man.
Even in England, you know, you brothers that go to the brothels and that, 80% of the women in there, are they not from Brazil or Colombia? Or those are Reubenite women that you're sleeping with, man. And that goes back to what? The reason why the 12 tribes are sleeping with Reuben's women is because what? Reuben slept with his father's wife. So that's the recompense of his error, which is me. You know, and that curse can only be taken away if it returns back to the laws, statutes, and commandments, man.
Right.
All right. So until you Reubenites return back to Yahawah, the 12 tribes and the rest of the nations as well, they're gonna keep sleeping with your women, man. All right. They're gonna keep doing it. That's why a lot of these whores are from the tribe of Reuben. Okay, they're selling the nani, man.
Yeah, I'm selling them.
And you got some wicked Reubenites as well that will actually give you their women and say, yeah, you can take her for a ride, but you gotta pay a price. So basically, that's where you get the whole PIMP spirit from, okay? Because really, most Reubenites are pimps, man, you know? See what I'm saying? Right, so let's go back into the notes now. It says, utilizing it on he succumbed to utilizing it on his father's concubine Bilha, which in turn activated the curse on the Reubenites, okay? The Reubenites' women being the number one choice for hiring in the prostitution industry, man, all right? This role is also easily played by them as they regard the rest of the tribes to be inferior in performance as compared to their Reubenite men. Because the Reubenite women, they know that none of the other tribes can lay it down like the Reubenites. So they ain't got no problem with letting you have a ride, because they know you ain't gonna hit it the way Reuben does. So to them, when you lie with them, they're laughing at you. They're just taking your money, basically. You know what I'm trying to say? Because they know they got the real thing back at home.
Right.
But because Reuben is under the curses and he can't excel like the rest of the tribes, you know, that's how they make up for it, by selling the nani, man. Alright? Right, so it says, easily played by them as they regard the rest of the tribes to be inferior in performance as compared to their Reubenite men. And it's funny because I'm sure Bilha must have known, man. You know? Because it takes two to tango, innit?
Yeah.
I'm sure he didn't rape her.
No.
She consented to it.
She saw him probably having shower one day. She saw the thing.
She was like, nah, I need to test it.
Yeah.
She seduced
him, so he was looking like,
wow. She was like, I want to test that one for a ride,
didn't it? You know women.
wicked, bro. Wicked, you know. And also, you know, Ruben probably, I'm sure, you know, they used to get together and, you know, have a party and stuff. And Ruben probably used to do that dance,
yeah,
innit?
No, yeah, exactly.
So she saw his rod, innit? So she probably saw the rod and she was like, nah, man, I need to try that shit out.
Yeah, and then he even saw probably a body, she had like a mad body.
Yeah.
And like, nah, man, I need to hit that. So that's what it is.
Man. There you go, man. Hey, because Rachel was what you classify as a bad B, man. So her handmaid would have been a bad B as well. You know, because birds are the same feathers flock together. So, you know, like the brother is saying, through the spirit of discernment, she would have enticed him.
Oh yeah, that's how.
And you know, Ruben, you can't entice him and get away.
No, he ain't gonna let.
He's gonna show you what time it is, man. You know what I mean? And I can guarantee you, it didn't happen just once.
No, come on.
It was an ongoing thing.
Because she got addicted.
Yeah, and then they got sloppy.
Yeah,
there you go. Because Ruben was slick, man, you know? He knows how to get away and shit. Because a lot of the traits that the other tribes has, he was the first son, so you have those traits. So he got sloppy. Just like Samson got sloppy with Delilah. Right? And he ended up losing his supremacy as being the head son. Just because of a woman, man. It's always these women, man.
That's why you have to be careful, man.
You know?
You lose your mind.
You lose your mind. It says many men have been slain by them. All right. Right. So it says, heavy curse laid by Jacob. Yeah. Right. It says, so the Reubenite men, and in turn, see it as an ease. Oh, okay. Let me start from the top. Right. It says, they're the number ones. The Reubenite women are the number one choice in the prostitution industry. This role is also easily played by them, as they regard the rest of the tribes to be inferior in performance as compared to their Reubenite men, and in turn see it as an easy way to make ends meet, as their men are hindered in terms of success due to the heavy curse laid by Jacob, okay, for that trespass concerning his handmaiden Bilhah. Bilhah means trouble or troubled.
Yeah.
Okay, which can be discerned as the current state of the Reubenite women, okay, a troublesome group of harlots laden with legions of demons due to their multiple sexual partners. Because every time you sleep with a man, you take on a spirit from him. That's what a lot of women don't realize. There's spirits in people, okay, and the scripture says, you know, when you get with a woman, you become one flesh. So what kind of spirits do you think you're attracting from all these different men you're sleeping with, man? Different energies are in you, different semens are in you, all right? That's why a lot of them, what, they got personality disorders, man. One minute, they got their head straight, and the next minute, I don't know where my head is. I need some time, you know?
Need some time. And that's the reason why they can't bond as well.
They're like, I need some time. You need to leave. I need some time. Why do you think they do that? Because they had multiple guys, bro. That's just how it is. You're taking on multiple energy because women are naturally followers, man. The reason why a lot of women in this society are destroyed, okay, is because of the choice of men they're picking. Because here, they have the liberty to pick who they want. And they're always upset. So what does that tell you? It's not that. That goes to show you that the father is meant to be the guy picking the man. Because here, you can choose who you want. Like literally, if you see a girl you like, you say, she can say no and there's nothing you can do. But she can go in anywhere and pick a guy and say, if a woman goes up to a guy and says, I like you, 9 times out of 10, the guy is gonna exchange numbers or do something. Because it rarely happens, isn't it? Because now, they don't even have to apply themselves. They can just go on social media, post a couple pictures, and someone will slide in the DM, man. This is the most freedom women have ever had at any dispensation in history. And this is the most miserable women have ever been. Because every time you meet them, they're always upset. What are you upset about? You got liberty to pick what you want, but yet you're still upset. That means that liberty is not working in your favor. Because it takes a man to know another man. A woman cannot know a man fully, bro. That's why back in the ancient world, the men used to pick wives for their children. The men, because a man knows what a man is capable of. A woman gets emotional, she overlooks a man's wickedness and get with him because she likes the way his beard is, or maybe the way his eyes is. It's all carnal shit. And then after she tastes, she gets a taste of it, and his real personality comes out, then she gets mad at the whole world. That's what's happening, you know?
Yeah, man, that's a fact.
So yeah. It says, another point to consider is the fact that Brazil, which is the number one haven of the Rubenites, because most of the Rubenites in the diaspora are in Brazil. That's a fact. Diaspora, the slave trade. They got, because you gotta remember, the princes, like the best Levites were taken. Sorry, the best Levites were taken from West Africa into where? Into Europe. The best Rubenites were taken from West Africa to where? Brazil. Yeah, South America, but mainly Brazil. Because they've been dispersed abroad, because the people make the place. That's why a lot of the brothers in America are confused. They don't know where the land is. Because what? The high priest is abroad, you know, the princes, the kings, the chiefs, the councilmen, the people that used to run society and make Israel what it is. The who's who's of the nation are abroad. That's why it looks like there's no man in the city.
Right.
It's because they're abroad. The Most High dispersed them. That's why he said, what, he's gonna gather them again and put them back in the land.
Right.
Because, hey, it's like a football team. If you got a football team with Messi, Iniesta, Xavi, Puyol, PK, okay? If you take one of those players out, you're making the team weaker. And then that's what's happened with Barcelona. All the guys have left. Messi's gone, Iniesta's gone, Xavi's gone, Puyol is gone. All these guys are gone, and then they're not performing nowhere near to how they used to. So now, a guy that's new to FIFA is gonna look at Barcelona and say, this team is not good. But it's because he doesn't know about their previous record, man. How they used to just mop teams up. It's the same thing with the land. All the Messis and the Javis and the Iniestas, they've left. So it's making the land look like it's not the place. It's the same logic, bro. The people make the place, man. Okay?
Kanawa, Kanawa.
Yeah, the people make the place. That's why one football player like Ronaldo, he can go into a team and the entire team chemistry just changes, man. The performances go up, the ratings go up, they get more fans. It's the same thing with us. You see what I'm trying to say?
That's right.
The Most High has dispersed the talent.
That's right.
Okay? So you gotta get this thing right, man. Right? So it says, another point to consider is the fact that Brazil, which is the number one haven of the Rubenites today, okay, hosts the biggest carnivals, man.
Whoa.
Yearly, promoting promiscuous attires, and in most cases, virtually no clothing at all, which can be linked, okay, to the recompense of Ruben's actions to defile his father's bed.
Oh. That's
yeah.
That's the upper.
So this right thing
there.
Is serious, man. That's why you gotta be careful how you talk to the men of the Lord, man. Because how you deal with us is gonna determine how the Most High is gonna clap back at you. Okay? That's what a lot of people are not realizing. You're talking out of the side of your mouth, but Yahweh is gonna use that to judge you, man.
Right.
And say, in as much as ye have said such and such against my men, I am gonna do this to you as well. That's what he did to Mashaha. Because remember, when Mashaha struck the rock with the staff, what did Yahweh say? In as much as ye have not obeyed my voice and have gone out of your own way to go and provide for the children of Yahshua Allah, when you know I am the one who provides for them, you're not going to go into the land of Yahshua Allah.
Yahshua.
And Moses was a very nice person. He was a good man.
That's why you shouldn't be too nice for Israel, man. That's one thing I learned. Okay, when you're too nice, they take it, they'll destroy you. But you, being kind is good, but you gotta do it with reason, you gotta do it with wisdom. If you give yourself to Israel, they're gonna destroy you, man. But they don't know how to measure. See?
Yeah.
That's learn from, me personally, I learned from my child. How to operate when I'm among Israel. How to deal with them on a day-to-day basis.
Yep.
It can't be too nice with Israel.
That's why when the brother called me, I didn't pick up the phone. That's it, man. You had a chance to be part of the new wine. You're lollygagging, okay? And this ain't the first time he's done that.
Many times.
Because even with the old camp, the Church of Yahweh Shai, before it split two ways, he was playing silly games, man. Okay? He came back in his own time. Now the Heavenly Father gave you a second chance to come back around. And now you fluffed it. So that's it, man. That's all you're going to get. So don't talk about forgiveness and brotherly love. None of that. Don't be talking about this. We need to get the work done. Okay?
Yeah.
You're halting progress. You're halting progress. So you need to get rid of those so we can carry on marching.
That's just how it is, man. That's nothing to do with lack of charity. It's about principle. Life is balanced, man. You can't be kind all season. You gotta be balanced. Even Yahweh, you go Yahweh Ha, and you go Al Shaddaya. You go Allah Shaddaya Salakia. Two sides of I'm darkness and I'm light. As much as I can love you, I can be cold as well.
Yeah.
If you violate, man. Don't you understand?
And if Yahweh Ha was so lovey dovey, okay, why didn't he just show his face onto Mount Masha? Why didn't he show his face to Moses? If he was so lovey-dovey. It says he spoke with Moses as a man speaking unto his friend. Why didn't he show his face unto Moses? Why did he show his back to him? Because that goes to show you the Heavenly Father is not what you think he is, man. He's an all-destroying, terrible power. Okay? And when you read the book of is it Ezekiel or Daniel? Even the angels don't see the face of the Most High. They hide their face, man, because he's got his back turned, not just to the angels, but to the world. It kind of reminds me of Inspector Gadget. What's that guy's name? The Claw guy. The villain in Inspector Gadget. Dr. Claw. You don't see his face. That's how the Most High is, man. He's got his back turned like this. So he's sitting on his throne, yeah? And he's got his back turned to everybody, not just us, everybody. Yahweh Shai obviously sees his face.
Right.
So Yahweh Shai will come to him, talk to him, and then he'll come back and tell them what the Most High said.
Right.
That's why Yahweh Shai got crucified. So if you see his face,
I'm done out here.
Smoke. So really, you don't want to see his face, man. And a lot of brothers are going to say it's a bugged out doctrine, but yeah, let's get the precepts on that. You don't see Yahweh's face, man. You only see his back like this. He shows his back to you. And it's funny because the footballers, every time they score a goal, what do? They turn their back
and you see,
they go like
you
that.
See the name and the number.
And you see the name and the number. That's how the Most High is. You see Yahweh, okay? And then you see the number, the infinite, the number 8, man.
Yeah, I think
that's Genesis, all spiritually tied in.
I like that. Get Genesis 6 get John 1 and 18.
You don't see the most high. So get the precept where Moses asked to see his face and he said, I'm going to show you my backward parts.
Oh, Exodus 33 and 23.
Get that, because the Most High, no one is seeing. The only person that has seen the Most High is Yahweh Shai.
That's quite enough.
Okay.
Exodus 33 and 23.
That's why he was able to tell the disciples, "He that have seen me have seen the Father." Okay. The Most High ain't showing his face to you dumb niggas, man. This is all you're gonna get.
Read it. All right. Read it out. Come.
He's got his back turned. Get the one with the train as well. The king, the train. His train filled the temple. Get that one.
This is Exodus chapter 33 and 23. And I will take away mine hand, and thou shalt see my back parts, but my face shall not be seen.
But my what?
But my face shall not be seen.
So Yahweh said he's gonna hide Masha in a rock, and he's gonna cover his face. Okay? And then he's gonna pass by and he's gonna see what? His back. Because no one gets to see Yahawah's face, man. Because Yahawah is a man of war, okay? And when two fighters are about to fight, what do? They have a face-off. It's like that. So if you face him, in his logic, it's like you wanna fight him. So you don't get to see his face. The only time you see his face is when he wants to destroy you. That's why his merciful side, Yahawah, is what? When he shows his back to you. Which goes back to the footballers, their names are at the back of their jersey, and you see the number. And that's what he's given us, his name and his number. Which is what? The 8, the covenant, the infinite number.
Not 7.
Nah, 8 is Yahawah's number. Because remember, Shaddaya is also 8. We did the lesson last week, man. So yeah, so get that other one as well. Because even it says when Yahawah was sitting on his throne, alright, all you could see was his cape, man. Okay. And the cape goes back to the Superman cape. You know the thing that Superman wears.
I'm trying to find it, but just like
Yeah, so no one has seen the Most High at any time. Even Yahweh Shai said that. No one has seen the Father. I think it's in John 1 and 18. Yeah, so get that. No one has seen his face, man. You know? Why do you want to see his face anyway, man?
Doesn't it say that
Yeah, yeah, but read that and then I'll get the train one.
John 1 and 18 and it reads,
yeah, I'll bring that down.
No man have seen Yahweh at any time.
At what?
At any time.
At what?
At any time.
Right.
The only begotten Son, which is in the bosom of the Father.
Well, there you go. That's the pure in
heart. He have declared him.
That's the pure in heart. Because he said, he says, read that again.
No man have seen Yahweh at any time. The only begotten Son, which is in the bosom of the Father, he have declared him.
You hear that? Yeah, only Yahweh Shai has seen his face. So when he said, blessed are the pure in heart, for say they shall see Yahweh, he's talking about himself. Because he's pure in heart. He came with a pure heart to do the will of his Father, man. And that pure goes back to who? Tahara, Apostle Tahara, who's Moses. Okay, because Moses was pure in heart as well. And Yahweh Shai came to take over the mantle of Masha. That's why he went to John the Baptist, who was Masha reincarnated, to get baptized, to take like the baton pass. That's why he said, I need to decrease for him to increase. That's why John got beheaded, went away, Yahweh Shai started his ministry. Alright? Isaiah 6 and 1. So get Isaiah chapter 6 verse 1. Because no one sees the Most High's face. He only shows his back to you. You're only going to see his backward pass. So imagine the Father sitting on his throne with his back turned to everything. That's how powerful he is, man.
It's like he's looking at things from the...
He's
from
watching it from his own perspective. Yeah. You don't need to see his face, man. He sees everything that's going on. Right? So his throne is not facing you. It's facing away. He's like, all the bullshit is behind me. You know, he turns his back to the world, man. And that's mercy. Because when he turns around, someone's dying. That's why the angels are what? Covering their
face.
That's
what I wanted to say.
Because they're afraid,
that's
man.
That's what I wanted to say.
Because they're like, oh man, I hope you don't turn around. I hope you don't turn around.
I'm going to come
forward. Yeah! Because when he turns around, it's about to go down.
Yeah, Yahweh is a terror, man. Yahweh is a terror.
Get that in Ezra. So get Isaiah. Read Isaiah 6 and 1. It's train. Because that train is talking about the cape. You know the Superman cape?
Yeah.
How do you see the Superman cape? You can only see the Superman cape when Superman turns around. So that precept shows he's got his back turned to this whole thing, man. Alright?
Ready?
Yeah, read it.
Okay. This is Isaiah chapter 6, verse 1. In the year that King Uzziah died, I saw also the Lord sitting upon a throne, high and lifted up, and his train filled the temple.
And his what?
And his train filled the temple.
And his what?
And his train filled the temple.
Right, so his train is talking about the cape, the thing that goes behind the back. It's like a long, it looks like kind of like a red carpet.
Yeah, this is for the guy, this is where the dark age.
Yeah, exactly, the cape, man. The dark age. You know what I mean? Yeah. That's his train. It filled the temple, bro. So it means he's got his back turned to the whole thing. That's why it says what? In Daniel, the Ancient of Days did sit. And the hair of his head, like, he didn't say what his face looked like, he said the hair of his head. So you can only see his hair, man. Right? Whoa. Because he's got his back turned. He's got his back turned like that. Okay? So get the one in Esdras. Second Esdras.
Second Esdras 8 and 21, and he reads, whose throne is inestimable,
right?
Whose glory may not be comprehended.
His what?
Whose glory may not be comprehended.
And what did Moses say? Let me see your face, your glory. Right. He said, let me see your glory. And he said, no man can see me and live.
Right.
That's what he says. So when it says, whose glory can't be comprehended, it means you're not supposed to see it.
That's right.
So him not showing his face is mercy. Because when he shows his face, he's going to have to kill you. He's going to kill you, man.
Yeah, finishing off, he said, before whom the host of angels staying with trembling.
Did you hear that?
They're hiding because
just in case he turns around, they don't want to see it. They're like that. Just in case. They're making sure. They don't want none of their parts of their body to see him. They're afraid. They're terrified, man. So you guys, brothers is going to begin to understand what this thing is really about. The new wine is bringing clarity, man.
Good.
And also, you're going to learn about your power. Okay, the right way. Because he said, I will make myself known unto you.
Right?
Right, so back to the Reubenites. It says, they have the biggest carnivals yearly promoting promiscuous attack. And also that whole carnival culture, it goes back to the Reubenites.
Yeah, it doesn't go back
it's to not them. A Benjamite thing, man. Okay? Because I know a lot of people say, oh, the carnival is for the Benjamites. No, it's the Reubenites. That's why when you go to it, what are they doing? They're dancing on people's girls. That goes back to how Reuben used to wind up on his dad's concubine.
So hold on.
Yeah, Bilhah, yeah. Right, so that's spiritually discerned, okay? That's why they got the biggest carnivals in Brazil. That also shows you they're the Reubenites, okay?
It goes to show that the people that came up with that carnival idea in Jamaica, they're Reuben, man.
There you go.
It's the spirit of Reuben.
There you go. So carnivals yearly promoting promiscuous attires and in most cases virtually no clothing at all, which can be linked to the recompense of Reuben's actions to defile his father's bed. So get Amos 7:17. Amos 7:17.
Well, yeah, that's it. That's
yeah, man. That's a Reubenite precept right there. Yeah. That precept is for the tribe of Reuben, man. Ra'awabana.
Amos what?
Amos chapter 7, verse 17.
Let me read it. Amos 7 and 17, and he reads, therefore, thou say the Lord Yahweh, thy wife shall be an harlot in the city.
Thy what?
Thy wife shall be an harlot in the city. And thy sons and thy daughters shall fall by the sword.
And thy sons and thy daughters shall fall by the sword.
And thy land shall be divided by line.
There you go, and that's it. That shows you where the land is.
Yeah, in Africa, that's where it goes.
Because Africa is the most divided land.
Yes.
You just see lines everywhere, man. It's crazy. Okay?
Yeah.
It's crazy.
I finish it off.
Yeah.
And thou shalt die in a polluted land.
Brazil,
yeah.
Brazil is polluted, man. Yeah. They got the Chinese there, they got all kind of madness going on.
That's right.
Alright.
And Israel shall surely go into captivity.
There you go.
Of his land.
There you go. The 10 tribes went into America, man. Right? And now they're trapped there. They can't get out. Because the Most High made sure they got stuck there. Because look how many Jakes are in Brazil. They still can't galvanize themselves and rise up. So, these are jiu-jitsu experts, men of combat. A Brazilian, if you get locked up in a room with a Brazilian, he's coming out, you ain't. But these guys can't organize themselves. So it shows you you're spiritual, man, you know? Right, so it says a precept, so Amos 7:17, a precept demonstrating the payback for Reubenites trespassing against Yahweh.
Yeah.
As most of the Lord's judgments will be specific to the prophecies regarding that tribe.
Right.
Whether it be curses or blessings. Going back to Genesis chapter 49 verse 1. Get Genesis chapter 49 verse 1 and then jump down to verses 3. Because remember, Ya'aykwaba put a curse on Ra'awabana.
That's right.
Ra'awabana.
Yeah,
Ra'awabana.
1 and 3,
yeah? Ra'awabana. Oh, Ra'awabana.
This is 9 verse 1.
So Genesis chapter 49 verse 3.
Verse 3. Finish it up. Ready, guys?
Yeah, ready. Genesis 41. Genesis 49.
Okay. This is Genesis chapter 49 verse 3. Reuben, thou art my firstborn.
49 verse 3.
Yes, that's 49 verse 3.
Okay.
My might and the beginning of my strength, the excellency of dignity and the excellency of power. Verse 4. Unstable as water, thou shalt not excel, because thou wentest up to thy father's bed, then defiledest thou it. He went up to my couch. Verse 5. Simeon.
No, that's it. Right, so it says thou shalt not excel. So that's the curse that came on Reuben, man. All right. So that took away from his majesty as being what? The big brother, man. That told all the rest of the tribes what they know.
Okay. Can I read a piece of that quickly? Yeah, first Chronicle 5, verse 1. And you read, now the sons of Reuben, the firstborn of Israel, for it was the firstborn, but for as much as he defiled his father's bed, his birthright was given unto the sons of Joseph, the son of Israel, and the genealogy is not to be reckoned after the birthright. Verse 2, for Judah prevailed above his brethren, and of him came the chief ruler, but the birthright was Joseph.
There you go. Joseph take Reuben's blessing?
Yeah.
Yeah.
So whatever Reuben was meant to get, Ephraim ended up taking it.
Oh, so that's what? South Nigeria.
Yeah, Nigeria,
yeah. The Europa.
Ephraimite.
Right, so Genesis 49. So Jacob stating that Reuben is the beginning of his strength can be tackled from another perspective. Okay? So there's other ways of tackling when Jacob said, Reuben, thou art the beginning of my strength. And we're gonna show you another way to tackle that. It says it can be tackled from another perspective as him being the most diversely skilled and talented son of Ya'aykwaba, as he would be the oldest son, okay? And also the dancing partner for the other tribes to learn the core virtues of what it takes to be a man.
Right.
So Ra'awabana is the one who taught the tribes how to be men. Okay.
Now, you know in Numbers 2, it says that all the tribes had the standards. They had like a standard, you know. I don't know how you call it. The Samaka. Yeah? And the Samaka for Reuben was a man. I say you can't make it up. It was a man.
And what was
the standard? You know, like every, you know, like this country, they go like those big flag, and then whenever they go, you do like it's the UK, like a standard. It's like the Roman. They had a big samaka with the moon on it. Yeah, that's what I mean. That's like a symbolic to represent who that country, you know, what they represent and things like that, right? And the one for Reuben was the men.
Yeah, so, man. So Reuben was the one who taught the fighting moves and all that. You know, that's why they're so good at the UFC Ultimate Fighting Champion. Because really, that's what Reuben is. Reuben is, he's the ultimate fighting.
They're the men's man. The men's man.
Because you got to look at it from a logical standpoint as well. Him being the older brother, he would have been the one defending the rest of the tribes. Okay?
Makes sense.
Because when you go to school and you get bullied, who do you go and call?
Big brother.
You call your big brother. And your big brother will be like, man, you can't let them bully you like that, bro. And then he might even punch you up. And he might even teach you, you know, some moves. And be like, yo, this is how you fight. You know, that's why they're such good fighters, man. You know?
Yeah.
Because they know how to box. They know how to do jiu-jitsu, mixed martial arts. They know how to, and also to be a good martial artist, you got to be a good dancer.
You gotta have that waist. Like
yeah. And that's how you know Esau is not a good fighter, because Esau ain't got that spirit to dance. Because to be a fighter, you need to have movement. You know, head movement. That's the first thing you learn. Defense before attack. Okay? The law of the ultimate fighter. Defense. Because exactly, because a lot of brothers, they worry more about attacking. But that's how you get destroyed, because even the Most High has a defense, man. Cherubim, seraphim, what do you think that is? Cherubim, charabayama is what? Plural for swords. And seraphim is what? Sarapayama. Okay, sarapayama, which is what? Fire. So he's got fire and he's got sword. What's that telling you, bro?
Defense.
That if you cross the line, he's gonna cut you down. He's gonna burn you, man.
Smoke right there, man.
You know? So Reuben would have taught the tribes how to defend themselves, because there were enemies around, the other nations. There were Canaanites, you know, the Hamites were there. Okay, so he would have taught the tribes, like Simeon, Levi, Judah. He would have taught them what they know, man, because he was the big brother, man. Okay.
Yeah, let me read something quickly. 1 Corinthians 5 and 18. The sons of Reuben and the Gadites and half the tribe of Manasseh of valiant men.
Of what?
Men able to bear buckler and sword and to shoot with bow and skillful in war.
And what?
And skillful in war.
And also, even in the football, who are the most skillful players?
Brazilians.
The Brazilians, man. They're the most skillful. You know what I mean? Because, and that shows you they're the best dancers, because if you see the way they you know, the step overs, it's like they're dancing.
Use their hips
a lot. Ronaldinho, he used to dance. Literally.
Yeah! He used to go like that.
He would do the samba and then boom, you go that way, he's there.
And he used to go like that.
It's normal, we're blessed.
And his control, he had mad control of the what?
Right.
Of the ball. Which can be spiritually discerned as having control of his balls, his penis.
Damn it.
Because his stroke game is off the chain. You know?
It's like he's dancing samba when he's
stroking. Yeah, when he's stroking, he's doing the samba dance. Yes. You know?
You know what I mean? Damn it. Oh, man, you can't make this up. You can't make it up at all.
You know what I mean?
And you know those
daughters of Shiloh, when they clap it back on you, they know how to control. So the daughters of Shiloh are like, man,
this guy,
what the hell? And it's funny because in Brazil they call it bunda. Big bunda.
Yeah.
Where do you think they get that from? That's Reuben, man. Come on, man.
Yeah, bunda.
Right, so Right. So Jacob, stating that Reuben is the beginning of his strength, can be tackled from another perspective as him being the most diversely skilled and talented son of Yahiquaba. As he will be the oldest son, also the dancing partner for the other tribes to learn the core virtues of what it takes to be a man. Okay? Whether it be in combat regarding protecting life and property, because that's one of the first things you got to learn as a man, how to protect life and property. Because people will try and come and take what's yours. That's why Yahweh put the spirit on Ra'awabana to have all those fighting techniques, the jiu-jitsu, the grappling, wrestling, because Reuben can choke you out and put you to sleep, man. And that's also spiritual as well, because in the UFC, he puts you to sleep. And you know, in the bedroom, he puts the women to sleep as well.
Right.
So he has his way, man. He's the ultimate man, you know? Right, so it says, regarding protecting life and property, or just general social skills, like music and dance, or how to deal with the ladies, okay? Because he will teach you how to talk to women. Yeah. You'll be like, you got, like, they call it game. I'm a player. I'm a pimp.
I'm a player from the
No one got game like me.
Right.
I'm going to teach you game, cuz. Yeah. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
When you go to Los Angeles, the PIMP guys there. You know, most of them are Reubenites, man. You go to Chicago, El Damaja Maha and his gang, those are Reubenites too, man. Okay? And like we were saying last week, they're into jiu-jitsu, mixed martial arts. That's spiritual, man. Okay? Right, so it says, social skills like music and dance and how to deal with the ladies. It is also fair to say that most Reubenites today will find themselves playing the role of a professional barber, career-wise, okay? And we're gonna break down why a lot of Reubenites are barber.
That's
you know when you go to the barber shop? That's a Reubenite thing right there.
That's it right there. Hey, that's the spirit, man. It makes sense. But you gotta have the spirit to understand things anyway. It's just like...
It's barber shop, the barber shop, man. That's where all the tribes meet.
Woo.
Because I don't care what tribe you're from, everyone needs to get a haircut.
I'm gonna show you. Oh, you cut yourself.
Okay. Right, so it says the Reubenites today will find themselves playing the role of a professional barber career-wise, as barber shops are the cheapest place of concourse in most Israelite neighborhoods, as is often visited by Jake to get him ready for the ladies.
Because
why do you go to the barber shop? To get a nice lineup, you know. So you can look good for the gal then.
Yeah.
And who's good with dealing with the females? Is it not Reuben?
Yeah, Reuben.
So who better to get you ready to go and meet the gal?
Reuben.
Reuben, man. And also Reuben means what? The head son.
That's right.
And when you go to the barbers, what's he working on? Your head.
My head. Rahash, man.
Rahasha, your head. And it's funny because the first character of Reuben, Ra'awasha, okay, Ra'asha, or Ra'a, okay, is what? The head of a man.
Head of a man.
That's what the character looks like, is the head of a man. That's why most Reubenites are barbers. They cut your head. You know? And they'll literally cut your head off as well.
Yeah, that's the spirit there.
Yeah, the favela guys, man.
Yeah.
They got the machete, they'll chop you up, man. Right? Right, so it says they'll find themselves professional barbers, as the barbershop are the cheapest place of concourse in most Israelite neighborhoods, and it's often visited by Jake to get him ready for the ladies. And the fact that Reuben's first Lashwana Kodash character, Ra'asha, which is the head of a man, okay, this spiritually equates to another clear-cut clue into identifying the said tribe. Barbers are often told by their customers to be careful when lining up the edges of their heads.
Right.
Because a lot of guys are like, don't go over the line. Don't go over my hairline. And that's also gonna show you another clue, man. Okay? It says to be careful when lining up the edges of the head, or for a lack of better verbing, do not cross the line.
Right.
This can spiritually be linked to how Reuben crossed the line with his father,
right,
Jacob, by going in onto Bilhah, his concubine. Because when he went in onto Bilhah, he was crossing the line. Because
right.
That was his father's wife, man. Right. So he crossed the line when it came to his father's wife. That's why spiritually, when you go to the barber shop, the first thing you tell the barber, or your main concern, is don't go over the line.
Pull it back.
So you see how the new wine is spiritual, and you ain't gonna get it. You ain't gonna get it if you're not spiritual, okay?
Definitely.
Right, so it says, by going in onto Bilhah, his concubine. Also, another point to consider is the fact that the gooks, or what you call the Chinese and the Japanese, the gooks always come into the barbershop to sell DVDs. They come in. Why do the gooks always come into the barbershop? That's spiritual, because what? Reuben took over the land of the Moabites and the Ammonites.
That's right. That's the spirit.
Come on, man.
Fact.
So that shows you that brother, Ra'awabana, he's a Reubenite.
And there's a spirit. Why would you name yourself? Why would you call yourself Ra'abana. That's the spirit right there, man.
Proverbs 20:24.
Yeah, men's going out of the Lord.
So brothers wanna hate on the new wine, but look at what the new wine is doing.
Edification, man.
You know?
Edification.
You gotta be a demon to hate on the new wine.
Yeah. Proverbs 20:24. Man's going out of the Lord, Yahawah.
Man's what?
Man's goings are of the Lord Yahawah. How can a man then understand his own way?
There you go. So that's another example to show you that what little things in your life can link you to your tribe.
Yeah, and that brother, I think he used to be. I don't know if he still does, but he used to be a barber. You know what I'm saying? And on top of that, his name is Ra'abana. So that's Reuben right there, man. That's a revelation. Yeah, he's Reuben.
I had that feeling, man.
Yeah, he's Reuben, man.
Yeah,
and
so
I'm sure he himself, he will think about, hey, and then he'll be like, wow, man, that's true. Because there's other elements, right, that are linked to Reuben that he sees in his own life. And he will be able to bear witness. Mm-hmm. But only he knows. So that's a revelation for you, my brother. Magnification for you, brother.
Yeah, man.
Zakwana. Ra'abana.
Hey,
that's Reuben right
and
there.
And through the spirit, he could be Reuben.
No, he could be Reuben.
He could be
the
actual Reuben from the scripture, man.
He could be the Reuben coming back.
Yeah, because he's the eldest guy in the group, isn't it? So he's the oldest son, so spiritually discerned, he could be Ra'abana, man.
Right.
You know? So don't say we never did nothing for the tribe of Reuben, man.
You know what I mean?
All you guys that say we're proud with this, with that, you know? Look at what the new wine is doing, man.
No.
And it all goes back to raising up the heads. The head son. Raising up the head son.
So you're so probably dealing with Reuben, man. The mighty Reuben, you know.
Okay.
I'm telling you, it's crazy.
Yeah, I'm sure.
I mean, it's not crazy. It's spiritual.
Okay.
Yeah, it's spiritual.
This is Numbers chapter 32, verse 27.
No, 32 and 37.
37,
and get the definition for Kerjathaim. Kerjathaim.
I'm on it.
Yeah, so read it first.
This is Numbers chapter 32, verse 37. And the children of Reuben built Heshbon, and Elile, and Kerjathaim.
Right, so now get the definition for Kerjathaim. And go to the definition A, okay, for Kerjathaim. That's going to show you that the Reubenites took over the land of the Goops, man.
That's right.
Who were the nation of the Goops?
The Ammonites and the Moabites.
Ammonites would be the so-called
Japanese. And the Ammonites, the Chinaman.
Yeah.
That's why every time you see Reubenites, they're always doing the Kung Fu thing. Yeah, because that's what UFC is.
And that brother Ra'abana is into some sort of martial art as well, man.
There you go.
That's the spirit.
And also that shows you that a lot of these A-lister Goop celebrities, they're Israelites from the tribe of Ra'abana. For instance, what's his name?
Bruce Lee.
Because remember, it says Reuben as well. Unstable like water. And what did Bruce Lee say? What was his famous quote?
He said,
you gotta be like water.
Like water.
Can you see that? That's mad, bro. You gotta be flexible like water. That's what Bruce Lee said, man.
That's his famous quote.
So that shows you that Bruce Lee is a good guy from the tribe, man.
You ready?
Spiritually discerned, man.
Okay.
You think Bruce Lee? Look how revered Bruce Lee was in the black community. Everyone loved Bruce Lee, man. And you're trying to tell me he was a goop. The guy didn't even marry a goop. He didn't even marry a goop. No, I'm just saying, they're saying Bruce Lee is basically a Chinese guy. He's not an Israelite. But what we're trying to say is, through the spirit, we can tell he's one of us. Because we had a connection with him. A lot of people used to watch his movies from back in the days, man. That's how, you know, the Reubenites, they had that connection with the tribes, man. Through the martial arts and all that, okay? And even one of the UFC fighters, you know, put that in the video. His name is Lyoto Machida. He looks like a goop, but he's from Brazil.
No.
because a lot of
the guy that was decent.
No. Lyoto Makeda. When you look him up, you see it. I'll send it to you later. He looks just like a Goop, but he's a Reubenite. And he fights in the cage. And Johnny Jones, the bones put him to sleep, man. You know? Because he had to show him the original.
The original Reubenite.
So this works, because that Lee, Lyoto Makeda, he was putting a lot of people to sleep, innit? In the armbar, he used to put them to sleep until we met Johnny Jones, the bones.
Until he met Big Brother, the real Reuben, I mean,
Jones the bones. Johnny Jones the bones used his own technique on him. He put him to sleep, man. You know? There you go. Because the original is always going to defeat what? The watered down. Alright? You got it?
Yeah. So the outline of biblical usage.
Definition A.
Slap here. Yeah, so the outline of biblical usage for Kari Athen, definition A, is a city east of Jordan in Moab.
In what?
In Moab.
In what?
In Moab.
In Moab. Can you see that? Reuben's land. So Reuben, and that also shows you that Ruth was not a Moabite. She was a Reubenite.
What?
Okay. That probably looked like a Goop.
Yeah, she got like the phenotype, she looked like when she'd been around. That's right. That's right.
You can't tell me. So, you can't tell me a Goop had a whole book in the Bible, man.
That makes sense.
And she's linked to King David as well. That don't make no sense, man. Nah, man, it don't make no sense. The Most High is not the author of confusion. And when he said, Ammonite or a Moabite shall not enter into the congregation.
Right.
So Reuben even set up within the shop compartments offering nail services to our people. Because when you go in the barber shop, who do you see doing the nails? It's the cooks, man.
You see the cooks doing that, you know what I'm saying?
So you see, the new wine is laser sharp. But brothers ain't gonna catch on because they're stuck in their ways. But don't worry, man. Shah season is coming, innit? They need a bit of encouragement, so they're gonna get it. That godly sorrow is coming.
Yeah.
Right, so it says, all this can also be spiritually linked to how Reuben took over Moab and Ammon's land in ancient times.
Sure.
Hence, them always being around each other. In some shape or form.
That's the spirit
this
right there.
This also shows us beyond any reasonable doubt that Ruth was in fact a Reubenite, possibly mingled among the Goops, which in turn will give her a distinctive Gook-alike look. Or Gook-alike look.
Gook-alike. What is the definition of Gook?
Oh, just Chinese. It's a slang for Chinese.
Okay. Oh, is that what means? Japanese and
yeah, when they're mixed with the Chinese. Yeah, like Naomi Osaka, she's an Israelite, but she looks like a Goop. Naomi Osaka, she's a tennis player. Yeah. And even Wesley Snipes' children, they look like Goops. You know? Yeah! Because he's a Reubenite. And we're going to break it down. We're getting to that. So, it says, and Ammon's land in ancient times, this also shows beyond any reasonable doubt that Ruth was in fact a Reubenite, possibly mingled among the Gooks, which in turn will give her a distinctive Gooka-like look.
Sure.
So in actuality, making her a Moabite Tess, not a Moabite by nation. So she was an Israelite that was known as a Moabite Tess because she looked like the other nation. Right, so it says, another example of Reubenites and Gooks' connection is a famous Reubenite, Wesley Snipes. Because Wesley Snipes was the first Marvel superhero black guy. He's actually the one who started the Marvel franchise. Okay?
And they took it from him, man.
He was, and what was the movie that made it take off? Blade. And the blade goes back to what? Sword. And the penis is what? A sword. Because the vagina is an open wound. And every time you have sex, you're stabbing it.
So you're juking it.
So it's the sword. So that shows you spiritually that what? Will Smith was, Wesley Snipes is what? Reubenite.
Reubenite, through the spirit.
And also he was a black belt. So he was into martial arts. That's why he used to do, you know, he used to do the combos and that.
You know, because why? Because he is a Reubenite. He's an ultimate fighter, man. Right?
And he, I mean, whatever his martial art, kung fu, and that, what's the Japanese thing?
Taekwondo.
There's the one with the sword.
Oh, katana
samurai,
sword.
Samurai. And
the katana sword.
The, all these people is taking, you know, that went today. And actually, there was a dynasty, I think it's a Xi dynasty, or the Xi, the Xi. They're the one that built up China and the Great China War. These are Jakes, man, and we know the Reubenite. Why? Because of the relationships that Reuben had with Mobile by taking over the land. So they're mixed at that time. So when Mobile left the land of Africa and went in that place where they are now, obviously they moved with some Reubenite,
some
man.
Reubenite, yeah.
And then the Reubenite after that went there to build up a dynasty. I mean, it's like, come on.
Yeah, it's spiritually discerned.
Have to be able
all
to,
the signs are there, you know? Right, so it says, so a famous Reubenite, Wesley Snipes, who is famous for movies such as Blade trilogies, and happens to be married to a gook. Because he's married to a gook, man. How did he get married to a gook? All these women in the world, but the spirit led him to marry a gook. Because he's a Reubenite.
That's
how Yahawaha shows us,
that's right,
okay, through contemporary examples,
that's right,
who is who. Okay. It says, oh, and didn't he make a movie called Jungle Fever as well? So that shows you a lot of Reubenites are gonna look like gooks, man. Okay? And put that video in with the gook dancing, because that shit was crazy. There's one gook, man, he's dancing. The way he's moving, yeah. And a lot of gooks are actually good dancers, man.
They can break dance.
Those are not gooks, man. Those are Reubenites. Because they're showing you through the spirit what tribe they're from. Because we know Reuben is the best dancer. Okay?
That's why. Spirit,
there you go.
Like Michael Jackson. You know,
exactly. And most gooks dress up like Michael Jackson. You know, a lot of gooks, they like to impersonate Michael Jackson. They do the moves and all that. And even Bruce Lee, yeah, that scream that he used to do when he used to go like, woo! Yeah. Michael Jackson does the same thing when he's singing, man.
He goes back to the moon in that, man. To the wolf.
Howling. At the full moon, innit?
Full moon.
You know?
That's spiritual, man.
Right, so another example of Reubenite, right, so Blade Trilogies, right, happens to be married to a gook who is, which is no coincidence, all right? This also sheds light on the gooks who are the best sword makers in the world. The katana sword, that's apparently the best sword, isn't it? And Reuben literally is and has the best sword, penis. And also he is like a sword because he's a fighting machine. So he's like a walking sword. Because like we said, you know, if they lock you up in a cage, literally a lot of them fight in the cage, they gonna kill you, man. And they gonna go and take your wife as well.
Yeah, because they got the best seven, innit? They just get number seven.
And it's funny because you come home and you see a Reubenite macking your wife. He gonna beat your wife's nanny up, and he gonna beat your ass as well. See, that's how it goes, man. Right, so it says Blade Trilogies, right, says, right, so the katana, and Reuben literally is and has the best sword. The penis, the seventh part of the body.
Right.
In the world. Also, his name's numerical totals value to a perfect seven, which goes back to penis as well, because the penis is the seventh part of the body. So let me break that down on the board real quick. Put your finger there for me so I don't lose the page or whatever. So we're gonna break down Reuben's numerical values, because we gotta do that. Because the numerics paint its own picture. Alright? So we got Ra, Ra, Wa, Ba, Na. So Ra is what? 200. Ra is what? 1. Wa is 6. Ba is 2. Now it's 50. So when you add it all up, you get 2, 5, that's 6. Wow! Right, so what, 2, 5, 9? Okay, so this adds up to 2,
5, 9. So now we're going to break it down. 2 plus 5 plus 9.
Yeah.
So that's 7.
16.
1 plus 6 is what?
7.
7, man. And 7 goes back to what? Sickle.
Right. They can be, okay. So they can fight, but then they're like a sword. Sickle is like a, it's a weapon, isn't it?
Yeah.
Ayana.
7, man. And it's funny because 7 looks like a sickle. Because look, if you write 7 this way, that looks like a sickle, man.
And the sickle in the...
And God adds up to 7 too.
Right.
So two completions. So the Gileadites, because God, I'm going to do God here.
That's
God.
What it says in the First Chronicle 5 and 18, that they were the very good when it come to the...
7.
The very good warriors, man.
And Manasseh adds up to 8, infinity. Manasseh. So that shows you, so our banner adds up to 7, which really the penis is the 7th part of the body. Because the head is number 1, right arm number 2, left arm number 3, midsection number 4, right leg number 5, left leg number 6, your third leg, they call it the third leg, innit? Your penis is number 7. So that, it's all tied into that.
Proven,
man. Okay. And what makes a man? His penis.
Right.
That's his posterity, isn't it?
Yeah, because they say if it doesn't work...
That means you ain't a man. So his number 7 is powerful, man.
So you have to chew the collar, man. From time to time, you have to chew the bitter collar.
There you go.
Man.
That's Ra'awabana.
That's right.
Sounds like Ribena, innit?
Ribena, yeah.
Ra'awabana.
Yeah,
Kanawakana. So yeah, man, so that's the breakdown. So the numerics don't lie either. How can you say we're making this up, man?
When he's right there in the face. Brothers don't want to study, man.
Brothers are lazy, man. They're lazy, man.
They don't want to do the work.
They don't want to put in the work, man.
They're doing the work and we're seeing the results.
But because it comes from us as well, that's why they don't want to hire.
Kanawakana. Right, so a perfect 7, which goes back to the 7th part of a man's body. So Wesley Snipes playing the first black Marvel superhero as Blade was no mere coincidence.
Yeah.
Proverbs 20:24, man's bones are of Yahweh.
Right.
Also, it's essential to state that Ruben is an ultimate fighting champion, which goes back to UFC, ultimate fighting champion. Or better yet, a martial arts expert, as he demonstrates his superiority in situations concerning Joseph. Because remember, when they wanted to kill Joseph, Reuben was the one who saved him.
Yeah.
Oh, sure.
Yeah. So get Genesis. You got that Genesis 37 and 18. Yeah, let my buddy Yahweh have. So read Genesis.
Yeah, just 2 days from now.
So Genesis 37 and 18 is going to show you that Reuben was the mightiest man at that time.
That's right.
Because none of the brothers wanted to step to him when... You know, they didn't, even Yaakov didn't want to step to him.
Didn't even face him when he stopped talking.
Yeah.
Exactly. This is Genesis chapter 37, verse 18.
Yeah.
And when they saw him afar off, even before he came near.
Now you're not reading the right precepts. Genesis 37 and 18.
27 and 18. That's what it says.
Okay. Kanawakana. Yeah. Kanawakana.
Genesis chapter 37 verse 18. And when they saw him afar off, even before he came near unto them, they conspired against him to slay him.
Right, because Ephraim was on his bullshit, man. He was pissing off the rest of the brothers because he was daddy's favorite little boy. And he was showing off as well with his brand new jacket. We are probably out in the field like we are out in the field right now. And he's probably home, you know. Same thing back then, man.
And even when you had a dream, like, you know, I think I'm going to be on top of you guys.
I don't think he said I think. He said it pridefully.
Yeah.
He said you guys are under me, man.
Yeah.
That's how he thinks, and that's how he thinks things are meant to go. So he was in that same spirit, because you gotta use psychology sometimes, and you gotta be spiritual. You gotta see how the brother behaves today, and then you can spiritually discern how he was behaving back then.
Yeah.
He was rubbing it in their face, man. That's why they wanted to kill him. Because it was to the point now where they were like, nah, man, this guy's taking the piss. And also, you got to remember, okay,
that Jacob really didn't favor Leah and her sons. Because when he was going to go and meet Jacob, he put the sons of Leah at the forefront. And he put the sons of Rachel at the back.
Right. Yeah, when he was going to meet Esau, yeah, he did that, man. So in case Esau
killed him,
he would have been the best favorite, man. This guy's...
That's what I'm trying to say. That's the part of the scripture no one wants to talk about. Yeah. But we're going to talk about it because we have the authority from Yahweh to talk about stuff like this. Read that. Read it.
And they said one to another, behold, this dreamer cometh.
Behold what?
Behold, this dreamer cometh.
Behold what?
Behold, this dreamer cometh. Come now therefore, and let us slay him, and cast him into some pit, and we will say, some evil beast have devoured him, and we shall see what will become of his dreams. And Reuben heard it, and he delivered him out of their hands.
And he what?
And he delivered him out of their hands.
Did you hear that? Reuben delivered. He delivered Joseph out of the hands of his nine brothers.
Because they were upset. He probably didn't fight them with like a few.
Yeah, he had to hit them off.
Something like that for them to.
They wanted to take him out.
He had to move them. And also,
it shows you how strong Reuben was. Because he had to take nine brothers on just to get nine versus one, basically. That's mad. So Reuben was not no easy guy, you know. And I'm sure they knew Reuben was a champion as well.
That's why they kind of like, we just started to put him, like, yeah, okay, thank you.
Yeah, yeah.
And Reuben heard it, and he delivered him out of their hands, and said, let us not kill him. And Reuben said unto them, shed no blood, but cast him into this pit that is in the wilderness, and lay no hand upon him, that he might rid him out of their hands,
right,
to deliver him to his father again.
Right, so if it wasn't for the tribe of Reuben, the tribe of Joseph probably wouldn't be here no more, you know? You understand? So that Ephraimite brother, man, you can't hate on this new wine because Kwamra Ash goes back to Reuben. You know what I'm trying to say? And if it wasn't for Reuben, your ass wouldn't be here, man. Because the rest of the brothers, they wanted to get rid of the tribe of Ephraim. Okay? Because you see how the Ephraimites behave. They're loud, they're noisy, always making noise, trying to disturb the peace with their madness. Yeah? When we're trying to get serious, they want to party bullshit. Alright? They're not serious, man. They can't take anything seriously. And all they care about is just money, pleasure.
Have a good food, man. Have a lot of children from Ephraim.
That's what they do, man. They love pleasure, man. You know? So, yeah, so they owe a lot to Ra'awabana. Ra'awabana. Yeah, that's it on that one. Right, so continuing. Genesis 37, verse 18. Reuben delivers Joseph out of the hands of his nine brothers, you know. One man versus nine. And you got to consider who the brothers were. We're talking about Simeon. We're talking about Levi. We're talking about Judah. We're talking about Dan, Naphtali, Gad, Asher, Issachar, and Zebulun. And Reuben took all of them on. Come on now. Reuben is a top tribe, man. Okay, because I haven't met a single brother that says from the tribe of Reuben. Everyone,
but they want to be Judah,
Benjamin, Levi. Even Levi is rare.
No, Levi, they don't even want to be Levi, man.
Levi, you know?
You know what I mean?
So it shows you every tribe is unique in their own way. Every tribe matters, man. All right?
That's right.
Right, so it says, so he took on nine brothers, okay? So, because Benjamin wasn't born at that time, was he? Right, so Benjamin had not been born yet, but the fact that a solid tribal warriors.
Probably didn't want him to move. But he said, I don't want to lose him again. I don't want to lose another one of my sons or whatever. I don't know. I have to double check. But carry on.
Right, so Benjamin had not been born yet, but the fact that Reuben took on solid warriors of Israel 9 solid warriors of Israel, okay, and overpowered them by himself, okay, gives us a unique insight on the fortitude and aura of the tribe, which is often overlooked. Because that's what it is, the tribe of Reuben is overlooked for the rest of the tribes. Overlooked as an irrelevant tribe, as Judah is the most coveted, okay, and claimed by all, which just pertains to Genesis 49 verse 8. Because Genesis 49 and 8 says, well, Judah, thou art he who thy brethren shall praise. That's why everyone wants to be from the tribe of Judah. There you go. So most Reubenites will also be into the mixed martial arts, like jiu-jitsu, taekwondo, and wrestling. Because remember, Jacob wrestled the angel. So that means Reubenites will be good at wrestling as well. Okay? Yeah. So it says, as Yahweh in his infinite knowledge would have provided Ya'aqaba with a first son possessing all these attributes to senior the up and coming younger tribes into the household names they are today. Okay? But Reuben deserves some credit.
That's right.
And that's what we're doing. We're giving him his flowers, man.
That's right, man.
For being the older brother we looked up to harness our true talents.
I know.
Because how do you think Judah became Judah? How do you think Levi became Levi? They had an older brother they were looking up to, man. Okay? Yeah, he did what he did with Bilhah and he got the curse. But ultimately, if it wasn't for Ra'ah Abana, none of us would have been, you know, the personalities we are today. Okay? Because he was the older brother that we were looking up to, man. Right, so it says he deserves some. Hey, that's why when you come into the land of Israel, he's the final boss that you meet first.
First guy.
He's the first guy you go meet, him and Gad. Okay? Right, so to harness the true talents, it says Reuben deserves some credit for being the older brother we look up to harness our true talents, chiefly being expert in warfare, as most Reubenites can have their way with you as they do with women.
No.
In combat sport. Okay? Because what do the UFC fighters do? They get on top of you and then they smash your face in, man. Right. In combat sport, it says some notable Reubenites we can use as examples are Michael Jackson.
That's right.
And we're going to show you. It says known for his moonwalk dance and grabbing his crutch, which can be discerned as indicating the Reubenite sexual prowess, because Michael Jackson used to grab his crutch and he used to go like that. Like that. That's spiritual, man. That's Reubenite. He's trying to tell you he's got the dick thing going. Right. Right, so Reubenite sexual prowess. Also, he happens to have made a song with another superstar Reubenite, Wesley Snipes, called Bad.
Right,
yeah. Remember that song he made with Wesley Snipes? I'm bad, I'm bad. Remember, Wesley Snipes was in the video.
Yeah, roller skating.
So that shows you Wesley Snipes is a Reubenite as well. And also, why is the song called Bad? Because Reuben was the bad boy. He was the bad boy of the 12 tribes. Because he was the only tribe that Jacob cursed. So he was the bad sheep, like the black sheep.
The black sheep of the family.
Okay. So Reuben, so another Reubenite superstar called Wesley Snipes. Okay, they made a track called Bad, as Reuben was the bad boy of the 12 patriarchs, aka the baddest man on the planet.
That's right.
Also, in the UFC, they have a title belt called the BMF title.
BMF, yes.
And what does the BMF title stand for? The baddest motherfucker.
The baddest motherfucker.
No, but hear this though. So the BMF title in the UFC stands for the baddest motherfucker, yeah?
Right.
Which Reuben happens to be,
right,
as he literally fucked his dad's woman, who can be his mom. So he is a motherfucker.
That's right.
So that shows you that the UFC
It's full of Reubenites.
It's full of Reubenites, man. That's my spirit right there, bro.
It's full of Reubenites, man.
That's how it works. That's how it works.
And also, what do you catch in cages? Birds.
Birds.
And birds go back to what? Women.
They yell them.
So they're going to trap you in the cage, and they're going to beat your ass, or they're going to beat your pussy up. So it's spiritually discerned, man.
You know what I mean? Slap it up.
You can either see it through the spirit, or you can just change the channel and say we're crazy.
Hey, he's what he is.
But that BMF belt, baddest motherfucker.
They said, do I be rude in speech and I'm not in knowledge. So.
There you go. Hey, the Most High created all things, man. All right? Right, so it says, which Reuben happens to be, as he literally fucked his dad's woman, who can be his mum. So he literally went to bed with, you know, his dad's wife.
That's
right. So Genesis 35 verse 22. Get Genesis 35 and 22. It says, Jacob learns about Reuben sexing his woman, but doesn't confront him until his dying bed. So it shows you even Jacob knew, yo, this guy is powerful,
yeah, man.
Genesis 35 verses 22. Yeah, man.
Don't want to go on his wrong side,
nah,
mate.
Nah, man. Because hey, Reuben was known. He was famous, man. Yeah. Just like how Michael Jackson was famous. How Wesley Snipes is famous. Okay, how the Brazilian football team, you know, Pele being the chief player, how he was famous.
Pele.
Because even growing up as a little boy, everyone heard about Pele, man. Everyone heard about Michael Jackson. These are men of renown. And one of the sons of Reuben, his name means renown. So you can't get away from that. So read that, Genesis 35, 22. Read it.
Okay, this is Genesis chapter 35. Verse 22, and it came to pass when Israel dwelt in that land that Reuben went and lay with Bilhah, his father's concubine.
His father's what?
His father's concubine.
And Israel heard it.
Right.
Now, the sons of Jacob.
No, that's it on that. Right. So he heard it, but he didn't confront him then.
Yeah.
He waited when he was on his dying bed.
Yeah.
That's when he cursed him. So that shows you he didn't even step to Reuben. So Reuben was a mighty man. He was nothing to be played with, man.
So you heard him doing the thing, but you kept it quiet?
Yeah, he just kept it quiet.
Don't you take a sign to
yeah, because
able.
Reuben was a warrior, man. Yeah. You don't want to step to him. Did you not see how he delivered Joseph out of the hands of 9 of his brothers?
I know.
So that means a Reubenite will rock you up, man.
Man,
of course, he was the strongest guy. He's the one who taught all the tribes what they know. Dancing, fighting, how to talk to women, all of that. Okay?
How to throw it down.
That's why through the spirit, Shah season, we know Shah season is coming because it represents Reuben raising up their heads. Okay? Spiritual, man. Spiritually discerned. It says, Jacob learns about Reuben sexing his woman, but doesn't confront him until his dying bed. This shows that Reuben was revered even by his own father, as he would have established his excellency being the first fruits of his father. Quickly reverting back to Michael Jackson's penis grabbing shenanigans.
That's right.
This can spiritually link us to the Congo, woo, the land of the Reubenites,
right,
who were famously known to have had their hands cut off by King Leopold.
That's right.
Get Deuteronomy 25 and 11. Because, you know, Michael Jackson used to grab his thing.
Yeah.
But through the spirit, okay, we can discern that the Congolese are actually from what? The tribe of Reuben, because they were the people that got their hands cut off.
Yeah, and they got cut off because they used to grab.
They grabbed
that thing to do the.
But there you go.
Right.
So that's how you spiritually, you see that?
Sorry,
you see how we're linking it in contemporary terms, spiritual precepts. So read it.
Okay, this is Deuteronomy chapter 25, verse 11. When men strive together.
When what?
When men strive together.
And in this case, our people are striving with the Most High.
That's right.
Just like how Yahi Kwaba wrestled the angel, they're wrestling the Most. Hey, they're wrestling the new wine.
Right.
They're trying to fight against the new wine. They're wrestling, man. Read.
When men strive together, one with another, and the wife of the one draweth near for to deliver her husband out of the hand of him that smiteth him, and putteth forth her hand and taketh him by the secret.
By the what?
By the secret.
By the what?
By the secret.
That's talking about his,
that's right,
his thing, his right, creepy member.
That's right.
Or his penis.
That's right.
Right, read.
Verse 12. Then thou shalt cut off her hand.
Thou shalt what?
Thou shalt cut off her hand.
Thou shalt what?
Thou shalt cut off her hand.
Right.
Thine eye shall not pity her.
Thy what?
Thine eye shall not pity her.
Did you see that? You're supposed to cut the hand off, man. So through the spirit, the Most High put it in Leopold's spirit
to cut
their hands off, man.
Leopold.
King Leopold was the King guy Leopold who went guy to Congo and chopped their hands off. But he gonna put it in the video anyway. The priest gonna put it in the video, so it's all good. Right, so it says, this is a clear indication of Yahawahah executing judgment specific to that tribe, as they often have the habit of reverting to the penis grab to solve most of their issues. Because that's how they get money.
Exactly.
You know, they sleep with these women, they get them booked, and then they turn them into whores, and they have them sleep with other men to take their money and bring it back to them.
Then,
that's what the whole pimping game is about.
I met one at work in a hotel. He's slapped all the women.
Well, there you go. And you get them to draw all the money,
to bring food for him.
There you go. So that's all spiritually discerned. So they revert to the penis grabbing to solve most of the issues, as this is their most notable superpower. Also, considering Israel as the Heavenly Father's woman who constantly trespasses against him, it is clear to see the dynamics behind the Leopold incident. Okay? The Leopold hand-cutting judgment enacted by the Lord through that maggot. Because that's what he is, he's a maggot. So Psalm 17 and 13.
No.
Because the Most High uses them to do his will. So the reason why he made the Congolese people use their hands is because it goes back to the tribe of Reuben, man. Okay? And Michael Jackson shows you that he's always grabbing his ting. There you go, so you can't make this up, man.
This is Psalms chapter 17, verse 13. Arise, O Lord, disappoint him, cast him down. Deliver my soul from the wicked, which is thy sword.
Which is what?
Which is thy sword.
Which is what?
Which is thy sword.
There you go. So the wicked is the Most High sword. So that's why he used Leopold to cut their hand off, man.
And also, we spoke about these bastard child of Israel in Europe. Well, they had even my mother, so it's all the same, man.
Yeah, there you go. Yeah, they're the wicked too, because they're from a wicked seed line. Yeah,
the mothers are the ones that put them up to be evil, man.
So he uses the enemy to punish his children. Most of the Reubenites are the most famous as well in their respective categories pertaining to their tribal origins. So Numbers 13 verses 4. Because the Reubenites are the most famous people in the world.
That's right.
Michael Jackson, the most famous musician. Pele, the most famous footballer. You know, Wesley Snipes is one of the famous actors in the black community. The first superhero in the black community, yeah?
So Numbers what?
Okay, so Numbers 13 verses 4. 13 verses 4, get Shamua. And get the definition for Shamua.
Shall I read it out?
Yeah, Shamua.
Oh, Shamua.
Yeah. So Numbers 13, one of the sons of Reuben, called Shamua. No, but we want it in the New Letter Bible.
Yeah,
read it. Shamua.
Okay, so
get the outline.
Okay. So the outline of biblical usage for Shamua equals renowned.
Equals what?
Renowned.
Equals what?
Renowned.
Right. So to be renowned means to be famous.
Right.
Okay.
Yeah.
And most of the renowned Israelites are from the tribe of Reuben. Like Michael Jackson, Pele, even Ronaldo.
Right.
All these guys, they're renowned men. And when you come to UFC, John Jones as well. Yeah, all these guys. Right, so it says, Shamua definition is renowned, which sheds light on certain notable persons of Reubenite descent. Like for instance, World Pele. Okay, often described as the greatest football player to ever live, he was very acrobatic and a true pioneer of bringing the rhythmic dance-like move
lives into the previously bland game of football. Because before the Reubenites started playing football, football was, it didn't have that much flair in it. They brought the flair, the stepovers, you know, the over the world, you know, style, like they brought like the dancing, the skills and all of that. You know what I'm trying to say? Right, so it says Ronaldinho, Ronaldo number 9. Most of these are renowned footballers and they're all from the tribe of Reuben, as the Reubenites are the best players, or should I say playboys, among the tribes. They're the best players. They play these women as well, isn't it? It says in the UFC, another notable fighter is John Jones, aka Johnny Bones. In contemporary terms, we use the word bone to demonstrate intent to have sexual intercourse with women.
That's right.
So that shows you Johnny Jones is a Reubenite too.
Right.
He don't even know why he called himself the Bones.
Exactly.
That's spiritual.
It was all ordained.
It was all ordained.
Right.
Also, Michael J. White. You know Michael J. White? He's an actor. He does martial arts as well. It says another martial arts expert acted a movie called Bone.
Oh,
why did he call it? Why? His famous movie is called Bone, Blood and Bone. And he called himself Bone. And what does it mean to bone someone? To have sex.
Bone.
So he's a Reubenite. That's why he's a martial
artist. Slap it up.
You know, because even that movie never backed down. He was teaching them. He was teaching them people how to fight.
Yeah.
See what I'm trying to say? And he was even teaching Kimbo Slice, isn't it?
Yeah,
how
Slice.
To punch.
Probably definitely a Reubenite.
He's a Reubenite, man. So, which he co-stars an Israelite foreigner who happens to be a Gook. Because
right.
Remember the guy that was in Blood and Bone? It was the Gook that set him up with the fights.
No.
So that shows you that's a Reubenite.
That connection,
man.
Reuben and the Moab.
You see that?
It's right there, man.
It says, all these are spiritually discerned clues, shedding more light on the tribe. Last but not least, Lyoto Makeda, okay, who competed with Johnny Bones, can pass for a Gook, but he stems from Brazil, which is the prime export, okay, which is the prime export zone of Reuben by Yahawaha, because he sent a lot of them to Brazil. Right, Joshua 13 verses 8, Reuben receives the first allotment of land. As the two final bosses will serve as the guardians of the East Gate, because that's the entry into the land of Israel. Also, if you look up Congo, it is the most resourceful country on the continent. It's got the most resources. Right, so pertaining to the prophecy concerning him being the most renowned son of Jacob today, another point to consider is one of the most famous world sporting events was held in the Congo, the Rumble in the Jungle.
Right.
Muhammad Ali and George Foreman.
Right.
Not Philip Manila.
No. The Rumble in the Jungle was held in the Congo.
Ali and Fraser.
Right, so that shows you that's the land of Reuben, renowned.
That's right.
And Muhammad Ali was a renowned man. He could be from the tribe of Reuben as well. You know, because he had the footwork. You know, he used to dance. He said, I'm going to dance.
That's spiritual.
I'm going to dance.
That's spiritual, you saying that, bro.
But he used to say it.
Yeah, that's spiritual.
He said, I'm going to dance.
Kana.
And the Reubenites are the best dancers.
Yeah, man. Kana.
You know? They're the best dancers, man.
Kana, what Kana?
Right, so it says, The Rumble in the Jungle by Muhammad Ali and George Foreman. Another famous Reubenite is Bruce Lee. As he was once famously known for saying, you need to become like water, innit?
Right.
You know, to be a good fighter.
Flawless.
You need to flow. That's why the Reubenites are so smooth, man. You understand? So Genesis 49 verse 4, Reuben is unstable as water. Also, Bruce Lee used to shout, just like Michael Jackson did. All these can be spiritually discerned using the new wine.
Wow.
So that's it on Reuben, man.
Wow,
okay.
That's a powerful one.
And with that, we're gonna close out. We're gonna face the east. We're gonna say Allah, Allah,
Allah,
Allah, Yahawah,
Yahawah,
Bahashama,
Bahashama,
Yahawah Shai,
Yahawah Shai,
Baraka Atta,
Baraka Atta,
and Manuwa Allah,
Manuwa
Allah,
Kwam Yashara
Allah,
Allah.
That's
right. Yeah, man.
Drinking his wine, laughing at us, saying, ah, look at them guys. He was doing.